News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the program where we show you how to use the language from the latest news stories in your everyday English. I'm Dan, and joining me today is Catherine. Hi, Catherine.
Hi, Dan.
So what's the story?
Today's story, Dan, is about a very big social media mistake.
Ooh, sounds interesting. OK, let's hear more from this BBC World Service news bulletin.
The Facebook chief, Mark Zuckerberg, has acknowledged that the company didn't do enough to stop data misuse. The social network has been facing sharp criticism after the personal data of millions of users was shared with a political consultancy, Cambridge Analytica.
So, Facebook founder Mark Zuckerberg has admitted that his company Facebook didn't do enough to stop millions of people's private data from being used by the political consultancy firm Cambridge Analytica. Now, the allegation is that that company used user data to help influence how they vote. Now, this has been in the news a lot lately. Mr. Zuckerberg has been called to explain his actions to two separate congressional meetings in the United States of America.
Thank you. You've been looking around at words and expressions that we can use to talk about this story. What have you found?
I found three great words and expressions today. We start with ramifications, then we have shoot down, and we're going to finish with the stakes are high.
Ramifications, shoot down, and the stakes are high. OK, well, let's have our first one then. How's the headline?
OK, we're going to Boston.com. The headline is Ed Markey has questions for Mark Zuckerberg with potentially very costly ramifications.
Ramifications, results or consequences.
Yep.
Where does that come from? What's that all about?
Originally, it's from French. The idea of ramify is to branch out, literally on a tree that has branches and spread in different directions. The idea that one action can have consequences which spread and grow and aren't always predictable from the original action. It's a countable noun. So we often use it in the plural. In this case, ramifications of the questions that Ed Markey's going to ask Mark Zuckerberg. We don't normally put a number, even though we pluralize it. So we're using it as a general plural noun. We wouldn't say three ramifications. You just say the ramifications are potentially costly.
Any prepositions?
Prepositions are. We can have the ramifications of an action, or there can be ramifications to an action or event.
Very nice. It sounds very formal, quite newsy. Is that...
Yeah, it kind of is, yes. It is. I mean, the idea of a ramification is we're talking something serious here. You don't have a ramification of, you know, something, you know, spilling a cup of tea, usually, unless you spill it on your computer. So, it's a fairly formal word, and ramifications are generally quite major.
So I couldn't say the ramifications of Rob eating the last biscuit.
Depends on how many times he's done it and what kind of mood you're in.
Always doing it. Let's move on to our second headline.
OK, so we'll go to Engadget. The headline is Cambridge Analytica tries to shoot down Facebook data sharing claims.
Shoot down, destroy, prevent or ruin.
Yes. So shoot down is a phrasal verb. It's separable, so you can shoot something down. And it comes from a military use. So, Dan, you're in your airplane flying in the sky.
I'm ready.
I am on the ground with my gun and I shoot at your airplane.
I don't like the sound of that at
all. And if I hit your airplane in the right place, in the engine or propeller, your airplane will stop flying and it will come down to the ground.
Yes.
As part of our ongoing air war.
So
shoot down literally means to shoot something so that it falls down.
Okay. This has nothing to do with planes, though, does it?
No, it's a idiomatic use of shoot down. In this case, it means stop something from proceeding, discredit something, destroy it.
Like an idea?
In this case, it's a claim. So you can shoot down a claim, you can shoot down an idea, you can shoot down a plan, you can shoot down someone's ambitions. In every case, it means stop them doing it, usually by telling them that it's rubbish, it's no good, it doesn't make sense, it's not possible. So it's using negativity to stop something from happening.
Now, Forgive me if I'm wrong, but you can also use it in a kind of a dating sense, can't you?
I wouldn't know, Dan, but I'm sure you can tell us all about it.
I have been shot down many a good time.
Oh.
So basically, it's used in the situation where you approach somebody with romantic intentions. Maybe you offer to buy them a drink. You introduce yourself.
Nice looking person.
Yep, exactly. You go over, you say hi, and they say to you, no, it's not going to happen.
Yeah.
Or they don't even say anything.
Look.
They give you the look.
The look.
And just go, please. And you get shot down by them.
Oh, no. And then you have to do the walk of shame.
You have to do the walk of shame.
Back to your buddies.
And all your mates go, oh, you got shot down. Yeah, it's embarrassing.
Dan.
Right, before we shoot ourselves down, let's go to our third and final headline, please.
Okay, we are now going to The Verge. Mark Zuckerberg is heading to Congress and the stakes couldn't be higher.
The stakes are high. The risks are significant.
Yes. So the core phrase here, the stakes are high. It's slightly elaborated in our headline. The stakes couldn't be higher, for emphasis. A stake, this is a gambling expression. If you are a gambler, you go and you want to bet on a horse or a football game, or you're placing a bet. The money in your bet is called a stake. The money that you give, saying that if I win, I'm going to get more money back. That's a stake. If the stakes are high, you're placing a lot of money and it's a very risky gamble. So it's about the level of risk. And usually, depending on the outcome of something, there could be quite a lot of damage, or potentially something could be really successful depending on the outcome. In this case, Mark Zuckerberg is going to Congress. They're going to ask him lots of questions. The outcome is really important depending on how these hearings go. So it's a very risky situation. The result could be really serious.
A bit like yesterday when I bet Rob that he couldn't make a cup of tea in 45 seconds.
Oh, yes. And what was the stake? What was going to happen?
Originally, he suggested a single biscuit, but I raised the stakes and made it a packet.
A whole packet.
That's right. And you know what? He did it as well. So I had to fork him over.
Hey, very good. I think I got one of those.
I'm glad he shared them out. He doesn't usually do that. Right, before we recap our vocabulary, let's go to our Facebook challenge. Now, this morning we posted, Facebook has acknowledged that it didn't do enough to stop data misuse. The prefix miss can be seen in the following words: misuse, mishear, misunderstand, and misplace. But what does the prefix miss mean? Is it A, not, B, bad, C, miss, as in the opposite of hit, i.e. to avoid, or D, female? How did they do, Catherine?
They did really well. A few people went for C, not the correct answer. The correct answer, miss, as it's used in these words that we're talking about, means bad. So well done, Vinay Chatarajaj, Bassam Yukub and Abdul Hamid Salim, and everybody else who said answer B, bad.
Well done, everybody. So, Catherine, would you mind recapping the vocabulary for us very quickly?
It would be my pleasure, Dan. We had ramifications, results or consequences, shoot down, meaning destroy, prevent or ruin, the stakes are high, which means the risks are significant.
Thank you very much. Now, if you'd like to test yourself on this vocabulary, there is a quiz that you can take on our website. That's bbclearningenglish.com, where you'll not only find a full explanation of all these words and a quiz, there'll be stacks of other videos and amazing things to help you improve your English. So get in there. Thank you very much for joining us, and goodbye.
Goodbye.
News Review from BBC Learning English.